Hi, I'm Caleb Chladek, and on today's episode we learn about laser tag. We'll learn a little bit about the history and science, we interview the man behind the process, and we partake in a few rounds of the game. So join us for laser tag.
Get from this to this? Well, I'll show you. Take it away, Caleb.
All right. So this is one of the barriers that's going to be on this soccer field where the laser tag arena is going to be played. There are the other obstacles over there. You can see Gabriel is setting them up. Hello, Gabriel. And once he gets them set up, the arena is ready to start.
Here, the boom mic guy and I were nice enough to help Gabriel. And soon enough, things are coming along nicely.
Yeah, I'm tough.
After scoping out the field, I'm ready to give some hard-hitting questions.
Hey, I'm over here, guys.
You are Gabriel?
Yes, my name is Gabriel. Yep, and the name of my business is Crossfire Laser Tag.
What does it take to work for Laser Tag?
What goes into like running my company, you mean?
Yeah.
Well, I had to build a good website and kind of figure out online advertising. That's a part of it. And then I had to buy a bunch of gear and create the arena you see before you. I used to be an elementary teacher, and this was something I did in the summertime. But it got busier and busier and got more and more business coming in until finally I quit my day job and now this is what I do.
So obviously the obstacles are probably different from the actual business area where, but what happens, let's say, if someone's playing laser tag and these obstacles fall, what happens then?
Well, surprisingly, it doesn't happen very often. Sometimes on a really windy day outdoors, they'll start to get blown over and I gotta stand them back up again. One thing the kids like to do is they'll grab a blocker and pick it up and carry it around with them and pretend like they're a tank, kinda. And I usually let that slide for one or two games and then I outlaw it, but it's always funny to see the first time.
Are there any dangers, physical, to laser tag?
Well, in 10 years of running, I saw a fat lip once, but other than that, nobody's ever been hurt. There's actually no lasers involved, so there's no chance of like hurting your eyes or anything. It uses infrared beams, kind of like TV remotes. So I'd say it's about as dangerous as playing soccer.
And you've done both indoor and outdoor?
Indoor, outdoor, in office buildings, in gymnasiums, in churches. Out in the woods.
How did the churches do it?
They move all their pews off to the side.
How popular is laser tag?
Well, it was hugely popular in the 80s. And right now it's starting to gain in popularity again. And part of the reason is that it fell off the radar is because in the old days, the gear could not work in sunlight. And that kind of ruined a lot of games and frustrated people. But today's gear can work in direct sunlight and it has all kinds of cool features and it works more like a video game. So because the technology finally caught up, it's starting to get popular again because it can offer some things that paintball cannot offer. So it's getting more popular now.
And it's less dangerous than paintball.
Less painful, less dangerous. Plus, you can do it places without leaving any mess.
Talking about laser tag history piques my interest, so I did a little research. The earliest known evidence of laser tag in human history was found in ancient cave drawings from northern Ethiopia. The fossilized remains of dinosaurs using laser guns were uncovered as early as the late Cretaceous period. Laser tag was revived during the medieval age as an alternative to the crossbow, but was proven ultimately ineffective against actual crossbows in combat. George Washington was the first president of the United States to use laser tag as a modern warfare tactic. Wait a minute, that's not right. In the 1970s, the military developed a system with infrared beams for combat training. In 1982, George Carter III designed an arena-based system for playing a scored version of the game while being inspired by watching Star Wars. The first Photon toys hit the market in 1986, but unfortunately went out of business. However, today there are different laser tag arenas all over the world with different brands and specs. And the world is a better place because of it. So says I, Caleb Chladek. The first.
All right, well, when the game starts, we will be utilizing the smaller blasters. Everybody starts with 22 lives. And once it gets down to zero, they get taken out. Everybody will be wearing a headband. And you've got to blast the enemy either on the headband or their blaster. Also works. After we've done that for a little bit, then we'll be getting out our sniper rifles. These big guys here. They have a reload like this. They have a little extra life. They have a red dot sight. And they do double damage, which is kind of the big deal. So they're kind of powerful. We'll be bringing out a medic box. So each team has a medic. So when their teammates get wounded, they can go back to their medic and get healed a little bit. After five usages, then you have to wait a minute and then you gain one. Otherwise, it would be too powerful. And then we'll probably introduce grenades, which is kind of fun. It kind of works how you imagine it. You pull the chain and you toss it. It has a 3-second fuse and then it blasts anybody that it can see. Took this guy out. This guy's still got two lives. And then from there, we kind of look at see how much time we have, because I got a lot of different games. We can go to respawn boxes and VIP games, but that's basically the basic level one games. And then if we have more time, we get more intricate with protecting your captain or escort missions, all kinds of stuff. But that's the basic introduction to the gear.
After learning about the equipment, it's time for a test drive. I enlist for a round of laser tag. I get suited up and ready to go. They say that war changes people, and I'm starting to believe them. Out on the field, you turn into a different man. I was a laser blasting machine. Now it's time for battle. I practice my evasion tactics and survey the equipment. I approve.
I feel like we learned a lot today. I won my first round of laser tag and learned some fantastic history. Special thanks to Gabriel with Crossfire Laser Tag. And I hope to see you next time where we go to Sky High Trampoline Park. Adios, and see you next time.
Mama pajama rolled out of bed and she ran to the police station. When the papa found out, he began to shout and he started the investigation. It's against the law. It was against the law. Oh, what the mama saw. It was against the law. Well, I'm on my way. I don't know where I'm going. I'm on my way. I'm taking my time, but I don't know where. Goodbye to Rose, the queen of Corona. See me and Julio down by the schoolyard. See me and Julio down by the schoolyard.